G'day there. I'm Jesse Crowe, the travelling scientist, and I specialise in immunology and infectious diseases. Today, I just want to talk briefly about the new COVID variant, C.1.2, or the Doomsday variant. Now, this variant of COVID isn't new. It was actually discovered in May of 2021 in South Africa. And since then, its prevalence has increased by about 2%. Now, this is a similar pattern of growth that was seen in the beta and delta strains of COVID when they were emerging. So that's why we're keeping an eye on this variant. COVID C.1.2 has also been detected in England, Switzerland, Portugal, Mauritius, China, the Democratic Republic of Congo, and even New Zealand. So what is this doomsday variant? Well, basically, it's a variant of COVID with many mutations. And a lot of those mutations are similar to the ones seen in other variants of concern, such as the Delta strain of COVID. These mutations are linked with things like increased transmissibility and decreased neutralisation, meaning that this type of virus is more likely to spread through populations easier and less likely to be impeded by the vaccine. The COVID C.1.2 variant actually mutates more rapidly than most viruses, and it's been calculated to mutate 1.8 times faster than the average COVID virus. But just because a virus mutates more rapidly, that doesn't mean it's more dangerous. Viruses are replicating all the time, and mutations occur very often. Most mutations don't change anything. Sometimes mutations make a virus weaker, and sometimes a mutation will make a virus stronger. But in general, more mutation does not mean more dangerous. So it's not clear if the doomsday variant of COVID will be more dangerous than the Delta variant we're currently battling with around the world. The doomsday variant of COVID isn't even technically a variant of concern yet, and it doesn't have a Greek letter designated to it. And the reason for that is that this variant isn't increasing in circulation that much. It has the potential to, but it just isn't. If this variant is given a Greek alphabetical designation over the next few days or weeks, then you can start to worry about it. But right now, just calling it the doomsday variant doesn't really mean that much. And finally, vaccines should still be protective against the COVID C.1.2 or doomsday variant. So if you've been vaccinated and you encounter the doomsday variant, you're less likely to be hospitalized and much less likely to die because of that virus. Historically, variants like this don't usually have much of an impact. They usually disappear. And it's probably just a hype in the media right now, but I will keep you updated. If you have any questions about the doomsday variant or COVID in general, let me know in the comment section down below, and I will keep you updated in the near future. Cheers.